Model-based definition, abbreviated MBD, is a way to display drafting information to document a product using 3D views instead of 2D views designed for paper. First question, is it a shortcut to learning GD&T? Well, that's an easy question. No, it isn't. But there are some more difficult questions you might want to ask. For example, here's an article published last year in Design News arguing against model-based definition. So what are the advantages and disadvantages of MBD? Does it have enough advantages over 2D drafting to make it worth learning something new? To take an honest look at these questions, let's get on the computer and show how it works in NX. If you search Google Images for MBD, you find lots of the same relatively simple demonstration models over and over. That might give you the idea that MBD is only for simple parts. There are few examples showing real parts, maybe because real parts are proprietary. Let's look at this realistically complex part we have been modeling in our class. It is the housing for our hypothetical oscillating multifunction tool. We modeled the basic shape using NX Realize Shape, used the shell command to hollow it out, and then spent some time adding detailed features. For our baseline comparison, let's first review the 2D drafting process. To create a drawing like this, we first have to decide what size sheet to create, or maybe even how many sheets. It is said that a good drawing should tell a story. For the introduction to our story, we populate a title block and add general notes to tell what the part is, what standards apply, and define default tolerances. We can even state that the user can get basic dimensions from the original CAD model. The story begins with datum feature symbols. The story gets confusing because we have to use multiple views to document the datums because we need to add these symbols to views where they show up best. So the reader must jump around to follow the story. Next, we must define the tolerances of features relative to the datum features. Again, we need to use multiple views to fully define features that are part of the same function. For example, there are four bosses used to position the brushes in the motor. We add a profile of surface feature control frame to define the tolerance of the top surface of the set of bosses. But we need to use a different view to add a position tolerance for the holes in the top of the bosses. And a user might get confused where we say 4x, not knowing exactly which 4 we are talking about. And then, as we add this detail, we start to wish we had started with a larger sheet, because notation from one view interferes with other views. The MBD story. Let's compare the same process using MBD. The language NX uses to write the MBD story is called Product and Manufacturing Information, abbreviated PMI. For this part of the story, I start the PMI application in NX instead of the drafting application. For the book to contain our story, you can keep all the information bound together in the same file as the model, or use a linked file. That is the same as in NX drafting. Although it is considered a best practice in drafting to use a separate file for the drawing, the opposite is often considered a best practice for MBD to keep everything in one file. The first real difference between MBD and drafting is that we don't create a drawing sheet using MBD. In the NX Part Navigator, we create 3D model views as we need them. A common convention is to name these views with the prefix MBD and a number. These model view names provide a table of contents for our story. Introduction. Let's open up the introduction to our story in model view MBD-000. To create the standard general note, I copied and pasted this text from another window into the note command. To create these symbols in the note, I used the GD&T symbols here in the dialog box. I added another simple note, like the title block, to give the part name and the product name. For both of these notes, I right-click and select Parallel to Screen so that these notes stay put when I rotate the model. Let me point out here that some users have figured out that they can create all notation using just the note command and the symbols it contains. This is not a best practice because this notation is not what we call semantic. Down the road, automated procedures such as machining won't know how to interpret notes created this way instead of using separate feature control frames, etc. Chapter 1, MBD-001. If you have any question which part surface is the datum feature, click on the datum feature symbol and the associated geometry is highlighted. I like to also create a chapter title in the view to which I add associated objects so that when I click on the title, all datum features are highlighted. The standards discuss the idea that the datum features together form a datum reference frame. We can create a real visible coordinate system and name it DRF-ABC. Again, by linking associated objects, we can click on the title, and the axes of the datum reference frame, the coordinate system, are highlighted. You might look at this as a negative on the side of MBD, because this is a step we didn't do in drafting. But on the other hand, the whole point is to create a clear story. One more thing to highlight. I didn't really need to, but because datum feature B is inside the part, it was clearer to see all these datums in one view using a section view. Notice that model views can be section views using a plane, parallel planes, or a box. Chapter 2, MBD-002. Chapters 2 through 5 are all based on functions. Chapter 2 includes the features used to assemble the case housing to other housing parts. To give a chapter summary, I have linked all the part features to the chapter title in the view so that by clicking on the title, the reader can see the cast of characters that play a role in the chapter. Because we are not limited by drafting views, we can document everything about the physical features in the same MBD 3D model view. Again, if you are ever confused about what 4X means, click on it to see what is highlighted. I'm not giving a sales pitch here. The linking of associated objects is not automatic. You must do it. For example, when I created the position tolerance for these four holes, I selected one hole for the leader, but I manually added associativity for the other three holes. This is an extra step you should do in MBD that you don't have to do in drafting. But the purpose is not really to save work. It is to create a clearer, more compelling story. Some companies have found that the real advantages of MBD is that there is less misinterpretation of the drawing information. Chapter 3. Let me just click through chapters 3, 4, and 5. These chapters tell the story about motor attachment features, the electrical switch features, and the features used to attach the power cord. Notice how the narrative changes to be about function, not just about drafting notation. I like to also create a view to store notes with external links. Create these notes with the URL note command. For example, I can right-click on these links to open them in my default browser. Here's a link to the user's manual, a product listing at a commercial store, and a comparison of similar competitive products. Index. An index to a book lets the user search in the order that they want. In the MBD story, this is provided by the function find PMI associated to geometry. An impatient reader might not want to read the story in the order we have provided in the table of contents. Suppose I am interested in these bosses. I query for what PMI is attached. This shows that a profile of surface tolerance is attached to a set of four surfaces. When I click on the feature control frame, it shows me the four bosses are in a set. When I click on the title, I see all the features that are identified as motor attachment features. Visual reporting. I'm not covering everything about NX PMI, but let me show you some other cool things. A useful presentation is to generate a color-coded visual report showing where different feature control frames are used. I click on HD 3D Tools, double-click to start visual reporting, select the FCF report, and click to activate the report. This display helps me check that I have not missed any important features. For example, I can see that I have used positioning tolerance on every hole by the brown color. NX tips. Here are some tips that might save you some time getting started with MBD in NX. Roll. The very first thing you should always do is to make sure you are using the advanced role. Without this, you will get frustrated when you find options missing in the dialog boxes. I won't go on a rant, just take my word for it. Drafting standard. You will want to use the drafting standard command to select your drafting standards. There are also PMI preferences for tolerance standards. There are also other drafting preferences you might want to change. Because my audience is from different companies using different international standards, I use NX out of the box with the default standards. Hopefully, the company where you work will already have set these as a default using customer default settings. Create model views. To create new MBD views, right-click on the Model Views node and select Add View. To create a section view based on your current work view, right-click the work view and choose Create Section View. In either case, name the view something like MBD-001 to identify the views and to order them. In any new view, orient the view to the plane you want for the annotation plane. Press F8 to align exactly to that view. Then right-click the work view and choose Save. You can always change this default annotation plane by repeating these steps. Feature control frame procedure. Here's the procedure I follow to create feature control frames and other PMI annotation in a model view. In the FCF command, select a characteristic symbol. You can define an annotation plane if different than the default model view plane, but I usually use the model view plane. Click and drag to define the leader attachment point, let up, and then click again to place the annotation anywhere, then close the dialog box. Zoom out if necessary and reposition the annotation. I often see something I want to change at this point. Double-click to edit to add associated objects. I will also change anything like tolerance modifiers and datum references that I might have entered wrong. After closing the dialog box, click the annotation to check associated objects. If you like to count mouse clicks, there are faster methods. But by placing the annotation first and then editing it, I can visually see what I've created to make sure I have it right before entering a lot of information in the dialog box. View orientation. After creating all the annotation, I like to rotate the display to the best 3D view in the model view and save that orientation. I also like to create a note as a title and select all the pertinent associated objects in that view. A preference to be aware of is the PMI preference Update Reading Direction After View Rotate. If you turn this preference off, the annotation does not flip around when the view is rotated to the backside. Some annotation is not displayed correctly when turned around backwards or upside down. Dialog memory does not remember your settings for each characteristic symbol. My tip is to create similar feature control frames together to save time, so you have less change to make in the dialog box. For example, flatness does not use datum references, but position usually uses primary, secondary, and tertiary datum references. So I can save some time by not alternating between these two types any more than I have to. Publish MBD. MBD is a building block to a model-based enterprise, abbreviated MBE. Unless everyone who needs to see the data has access to NX, you need to publish the MBD information. Depending on how you work, you can share the MBD information using a JT file with TeamCenter or a separate 3D file viewer. You can also export views into 2D PDF files. You might prefer to publish the 3D model views in a 3D PDF using an external solution, for example, from Anark or Theorem. I will give some links below this video. Yes, there are hurdles to adopting a new process and a new way to publish product documentation, but I hope you can see how MBD can be a better way to tell a story in 3D than with 2D drafting. Thanks for watching.